So you should end up with, on the USB, two files like called this. So when you first down like load it, it's going to be a zip file. So double click on the zip file, it'll extract it to like a folder, and you get two files that have a .apk at the end. So this is what you want to have on your like USB. Then I'm going to inject the USB and put it into our unit. Some install instructions here, like how to put the mode app on your like unit. So if you come here, a VD like mode, that's going to take you to this page right here. Scroll down, it's just going to say some steps. Make sure you have the latest firmware on your like unit. If you don't have the like latest firmware, you can try it without and see if it works. It should still work. We just haven't tested it on every single one. So you could try, you could sort of skip the stage and like try this. There's actually two different like versions. So this one here is for the normal like M series. So to check if you have like an M series, we will put a little like picture up here to help you guys out. But if you bought a unit from us in the past sort of year and a half, it should be M series. And then if you got so of course if you got like a widescreen version, which this is a big, it's a bit more of like a rectangle, sort of a wide rectangle, you have a different app here. So we're going to download this, click on here, this will download to your computer, and then if you open up your Finder here, what you want to do is you want to download what you've just downloaded and drag it onto the directory drive, so the first drive of the USB. So what we have to do is put like a USB into a USB port that you have coming from the head unit. You should see it. You should see it like pop up the top there.
You are tired.
So once the USB's in, so you're just going to come into here. You're looking for APK installer. You got the USB put in. Now the first one you want to do is a main app. So click on there. Install. And you can just click done. When you do install this one, it might just remove the FCAM off here. You can just touch on here and put FCAM back or whatever apps you had there, because it's going to put it back to what it was. So that is the first step. And then the second step is to come in here and then again go to the APK installer. Oh, sorry, there it is up there. And install VDM mode. So install. You might get something saying I can't install from this thing. If you get that, you click on that and you got to click a little like sort of slider here to like allow, and then click back and you'll be able to go through. So done. So that is both things installed now. So we should be able to come here and go into the VDM mode app. First thing you can do is actually like click on here. One or more permissions need to be granted. Go into permissions, give all these permissions. You can see I'm giving, press the back button, back again. Permissions, location, turn that one on. That's okay, usage. You can turn that one on like that and then go back again. It's a bit annoying when you go back, it takes you back to the home screen, but that is how it is. So all those permissions on, and then tap other VDM mode again. All right, cool. So we just got to select an app and activity. So under app and activities, set navigation app to the auto link or like car letter, depending what you are like using, because that's going to be CarPlay or like Android Auto. If you use any other ones, you can also put that as a kind of like a navigation app. The difference between like navigation apps and like normal apps is just the way the like system suggests what ones to use. So that's our navigation apps. And then you can come in here and select the other ones you might want to use. So we could,
please fasten your seatbelt.
So we could do car scanner. We could come in here and do, now you could do the dash cam. All your other extra ones are a bit like random to get to, but they're like going to be under this like main UI thing. So if I click this little arrow over here, it actually comes in and so it gives me a lot of things here. So common ones to use could be the reverse camera radio. Let's give it that one. Or like the FCAM, because you could have your caravan camera on there or like something. FCAM. Those are probably going to be the sort of main ones you do use. We can provide some extra advice here if you need it. But if you had extra apps on here, they would also come up in here. So that's basically that. So we've set those two apps. Add back, that's fine. Add launch, we will add that. It just gives us like a home icon, which is handy to get back to like the main screen. Now that's done, you can actually click that and it
as I would like started. So to test it, press the like mode button on your steering wheel now, or the source button, and you can see that's how it sort of works. So if I come in here and I go, oh, I want to go home, it takes me home. Or if I'm like, oh, I want to go to CarPlay or like Android Auto, it can open up CarPlay, Android Auto. So it just provides like it's like a useful way to like sort of actually use the mode or like source button how it was designed. Now if we come back into here, there's a few other like settings. We've done the apps and activity dialogue. You can probably put this a bit slower, so that is the time. So I probably like prefer to like normally have it about like one. Show the clock, brightness of not selected actual sort of items, so you can change it sort of down a bit if you want. Gray scale are not selected ones, so it just means you can sort of easier see the one you're after. Play that key sound, so you could turn that off if you're not into having that sound come up. So you can see that's pretty easy for me to find actually what I need to find. Back obviously just gets sort of rid of the screen. Screen now, this is quite cool. So some customers say, hey, I'm driving at night time and it's still too bright on like sort of max dim. So you can actually put this quite dim, and it actually puts like an overlay over the screen, so it actually kind of sort of like a workaround to get the screen like really dim. So you can like set that up, and like that will actually like come on at sort of sunset and like sunrise. So it'll like come on at sunset and it'll like come off at sort of like sunrise. So if you like always drive with your headlights on, which a lot of people do here, so what you can actually do is like turn that headlight like mode off. So if I come into here, settings, car infotainment, display, this auto mode here, if I turn off that, you can see I'm turning my headlights on and off now, and obviously sort of nothing's happening, and like here it dims. So I could go, okay, max daytime backlight, turn that like off, and then what's going to happen is it's gonna pushing the wrong thing, I rely on this app here to put it into dim mode. And if you come into here and you click on here, you can see that's how dim it will be, to give you an idea, like that. So what you want to have it on for like auto mode is the moon and the sun, and like that I'll put it on like auto mode. And you can see here, if we dim that a bit more, you can see how like dim it gets. Now you can't actually see that, but at night time you would actually be able to like see it. So you can see how dim you can actually like sort of make the screen, which is pretty cool. So that's gonna like overpower that. Great little feature if you use your lights all the time. And to turn it on, you have to go and do it like that. Auto start, don't sort of worry about like any of this. There is something a bit more advanced on here. There's an app called like Automate. We'll dig into that like later on, but it allows you to do like, if this opens, then do this. If this does that, I'll then do that. It's a pretty advanced thing, and we like will sort of, I will give some of that, I guess, other more advice of that in the future. Others, don't have to worry about that. So that is like basically how you install this app, and I will just show you sort of. So if we turn the car off, it's probably gonna take a little bit of time. So when it comes back on, you'll see that it will start up, and you should get starting video mode. So that happens automatically now. So if I push this button again, it is going through all our things. So I guess the handy things to do are like, oh yep, I could like quickly go to like CarPlay, or I can go to my caravan rear view camera, or I can like be like, I need to go to my car scanner app, or I want to switch to like the radio, etc. So it allows the mode button to do what like it used to do. So that should cover the whole install process after putting the video app on.